we do. I said, get it. Sing along. Let's go. Transformation. Places, Lord God, where your love will dwell. Places, Lord God, where there will be resources.
Why we're here, the reason why, is because in other parts of the city, these developments are not welcome. Not in South LA. Here, we celebrate them. We celebrate them with the people that live in them. So this morning, we'll hear from incredible folks that made the development of these two projects happen. They're right here with us. But before I continue, we have the personnel department right here, ready to hand out jobs. The council member will always say this, we have thousands of jobs in the city, completely vacant. Please come and see what job fits.
Art Walker.
Thank you all for being here with us today. I'm Mary Jane Wagley with Works. And we are so honored to be celebrating the fact that this community is welcoming individuals and families.
Thanks to Councilman Marquis Sarah Dawson and to Mayor Bass for
asking. Shortages of appliances from Mexico.
Okay, 1, 2, 3. Perfect. Thank you so much.
Just ready for me to get in with my kids and start my new life with them, you know, and focus about them and not about housing anymore, you know, just pay my rent that is not even high, you know. That's another blessing that they help here so much.
Thank you
very much.
One of 43 stories. Thank you.
Let's clap it up for Elizabeth Monterrosa one more time.
We see day to day. I want to give this development, but also we want to introduce to you Malik Wilson, who is a tenant there. So Scott Baldridge is the president of the firm that pulled this together, and he's a partner of Hope Street Development Group, who is a joint venture between ADIS Real Estate.
We've put a down payment on that today here on Crenshaw. Is our own mayor from our neighborhood, the leader of the city of Los Angeles, the one and only Karen Ruth Bass.
Hello, everybody. Good afternoon. How's everybody doing today? Isn't it nice to have a day in LA where we can celebrate? Celebrate our people getting housed. And I had the opportunity a few minutes ago to talk to the folks that are living in there, and this is life changing. This is the change that can happen all over our city. But I just want to talk about the councilman for a minute. I don't want him to listen. Close your ears. He was in the city council for about a month before he saw the need to have voters all weigh in to help get the housing built. And so he led the effort for Proposition HHH that everybody says nothing happened because of Proposition HHH. Well, the next time you hear somebody say that, you pull out your cell phone and you show them a picture of this building here and that building there, and you say, we have proof for what happened. That's why voters vote. And you're going to have an opportunity to do that again in March, because we need more money. We have to make sure we take care of those people who are struggling with mental health and substance abuse, and you'll have an opportunity to vote for that in March. But we are here celebrating what I believe is one of the most important issues in our city right now. We want to change South LA. And we know that residents of South LA disproportionately are the ones who are unhoused on our streets. We also know that one of the fastest growing sectors of the unhoused population are our elders. Our elders. You judge a society by how they treat those who are at the beginning of the life cycle and those who are up near the end of the life cycle. That's how you judge a society. And today we are showing that we know when there is a problem, we come together and we can get it solved. But Crenshaw is changing. Now, he didn't just do HHH. He had to do Destination Crenshaw also to make sure that this street never forgets, this city never forgets the historic roots of Crenshaw. And we want to promote cultural tourism. There is more to see LA than Hollywood. Hollywood is wonderful, but Destination Crenshaw is good also. also want to thank St. Joseph Center and Hopix. St. Joseph, I see you waving your hand, Miss new CEO. And Miss former CEO, Valicia Adams Kellum, doctor, who is the head of LASA in our county and our lead partner in making sure that we can get our people housed. Thank the developers that put this on. Can I have those certificates? Joanne, will you hand me that? Mark, Walther, I see you there taking pictures. Work in our community, and you do wonderful work for the mayor's office. Our former mayor, Eric Garcetti, and also with me, we have a certificate for you to hang up. I do have to tell you, though. Well, it's already hung up? Well, oh, okay. They're bringing it to me. Thank you very much. All right. GTM Holdings. Just for the photo. I have one more. Do I have one more? Oh, Works, Women Organizing Resources, Knowledge, and Services on celebrating the grand opening. Thank you so much for your efforts. You know, that's another thing that Angelenos feel, that who's dealing with homelessness in our city? We have community-based organizations that know exactly what to do, that know how to get people off our streets, that know how to have them go back into the mainstream after they dealt with whatever led to them being unhoused. The community-based organizations that do this work day in and day out need more resources, need more support, and need more love from Angelenos. All right. Thank you, everyone. Have a wonderful weekend. That's a great way to begin. Yes, it is.